In 2009, the campaign group Families Need Fathers produced a set of guidelines on shared parenting. These were intended to help both parents following a divorce or separation to retain a positive role in their children's lives. However, these guidelines have found criticism from Joan Hunt of the University of Oxford, Judith Masson of the University of Bristol, and Liz Trinder of the University of Exeter. Their main criticisms are that the guidance and the inclusion of a 50-50 presumption does not reflect the current law, and that they present a distorted interpretation of the available research evidence. There was also a concern that they did not have official approval. An important consideration when dealing with these criticisms is that the academics all come from a social, legal background. Therefore, although they emphasize the importance of the children's wishes and feelings in accordance with the welfare checklist, the Children's Act 1989 states the child's welfare is the court's paramount consideration, and this must by definition also include the needs of the child. Most would accept that children need a family and the input of both parents. However, this last proposition is contested by the academics. Specifically, the Children's Act 1989 does make provision for the sharing of residence by two or more people who do not live together by giving the court power to determine the time the child spends with each. However, the academics maintain there is no suggestion that this is the preferred arrangement. Indeed, the idea of a preferred arrangement conflicts with the individualized approach which is fundamental to the welfare principle. They refer to Parliament, which they say only recently rejected attempts to enshrine in law a presumption that the child's time should be shared between separated parents, and that such a presumption would necessarily compete with the paramountcy of the child's welfare. But it is important to note Parliament was voting to allow judges' discretion. It did not outlaw shared parenting. The critics of shared parenting recognise the importance of the role of the judiciary by referring to the judgments made by Baroness Hale. They quote Lord Hoffman, who said Baroness Hale's opinion should be required reading by family court judges dealing with residence orders. Baroness Hale made 4 points relating to children, which the academics include in their criticism of the shared parenting guidelines. 1. Applying the welfare test means the court must choose from the available options for the future which will be best for the children, not the future which will be best for the adults. 2. There were major advantages in avoiding conflict and achieving agreed solutions because these could best suit the parents' and children's circumstances. Parents who could negotiate could adjust arrangements as circumstances changed without involving the courts. Even if orders were imposed, the parents were always free to agree alternatives. 3. Family court orders are meant to provide practical solutions to the practical problems faced by separating families. They are not meant to be aspirational statements of what would be for the best in some ideal world which has little prospect of realization. An arrangement where the children had homes with each of their separated parents was not usually practicable, because family courts had no powers to conjure up resources where none exist. 4. Shared residence orders were not necessary to ensure that a separated father had parental responsibility and could make decisions during contact. This could be achieved by a Section 4 parental responsibility order or agreement. Baroness Hale is cited by the academics because she is an architect of the Children's Act 1989. She is also the first female law lord and has an instrumental role in shaping future legislation. It is therefore important for the argument to show they understand the intention behind the law. However, Baroness Hale also said, as Lady Hale on the Court of Appeal on this issue in 2003, he argues that one of the purposes of the Children's Act 1989 was to redress the balance, to promote a more equal sharing of responsibility for children between mothers and fathers, and to promote the maintenance of a good relationship as possible between children and each of their parents should, unhappily, their parents not be living together. The father is correct that that was one of the principles behind the Children Act 1989, in which I take a certain amount of pride. The father points out that he has a certain amount of pride, so I make that comment in response. In January 2006, also in the Court of Appeal, Lord Justice Thorpe, sitting with Lord Justice Wall, stated that the whole tenor of recent court authority had been to liberate trial judges to elect for a regime of shared residence if the circumstances and the reality of the case supported that conclusion. The effect of their judgment was to elevate the father in the proceedings from a so-called contact parent to a parent which was termed a full parenting role. The academics' attack on shared parenting seems like an attack on the family, and despite their words, there is a dearth of research criticizing shared parenting. Because of the significance the disciplines of child psychology and child sociology attach to the importance of contact between children and their parents, recognizing the wishes and feelings of a child is not the same as being child-centered. And the result is that these academics see the child's welfare through the eyes of a child, which leads them to draw superficial and simplistic conclusions. For example, they highlight the importance of parents' relationship equipment, including adequate trust and regard, ability to make joint decisions, flexibility, passive cooperation, effective containment of conflict, and parent pragmatic resources, including flexibility and a desire to make the arrangement work. But most parents already know that they should not argue in front of the children. The problem is you cannot make people care by sending them back to the classroom. This way forward is very much the same sort of aspirational statement which Baroness Hale criticized. The law is never static. It is a product of society, and shared parenting has been introduced in places as far afield as Belgium and Australia. It is also gradually being adopted state by state across America, where now more applications in family courts result in shared residence orders than orders for contact. This trend is not the result of any preconceived notion based on parents' rights, wishes, or views of fairness. It is because shared parenting is in the child's best interests, and families need fathers should be applauded, not criticized, for producing these guidelines.